Congressman Joe Courtney finally got to see the movie Lincoln in recent days. He was riveted by the scenes showing the debate in the House of Representatives over the 13th Amendment outlawing slavery.
Congress must never declare equal those whom God created unequal.
Later, the climactic scene, the actual vote. We're not allowed to show you the clip, but here's what the characters said. The clerk of the House, quote, "We begin with Connecticut, Mr. Augustus Benjamin, on the matter of this amendment. How say you?" Benjamin, "Nay." The clerk, Mr. Arthur Bentley. Bentley, "Nay." So two congressmen from Connecticut voted against abolishing slavery?
It just said, you know, something's wrong here. I mean, this just cannot possibly be correct.
Courtney, who represents Connecticut's 2nd District, was bugged about it all the way home. When he got home, he Googled the information, thought he was onto something. Then Courtney got with the Congressional Research Service, part of the Library of Congress, asked them to check the historical records. They did and quickly got back to him with the news that he was right, that all four members of Connecticut's House delegation had voted in favor of the amendment. Courtney's written a letter to director Steven Spielberg saying, "I could not believe my own eyes and ears that the movie wrongly depicted Connecticut's delegation as being on the wrong side of history."
That's a source of information that a lot of people may never get any other source in terms of the history of the Civil War or the 13th Amendment.
The names of the Connecticut congressmen, like most names for congressmen in the movie, were made up. But we found no other voting inaccuracies in the film. I spoke about it with Lincoln historian Christian McWhirter.
But Hollywood movies frequently have these kind of errors in them. And Lincoln is an exceptionally good Hollywood historical film. And so I think we have to have a certain amount of tolerance for a certain amount of error.
Indeed, the movie isn't a documentary, doesn't claim to be one. It's historical fiction and doesn't have to be 100% accurate.
But Congressman Courtney has asked that that part of the movie be corrected before it's released on DVD later this month. CNN has reached out to representatives for director Steven Spielberg, for screenwriter Tony Kushner, and the distributor Disney, asking for response to Congressman Courtney's complaints and asking if the DVD version will have a correction. We have not heard back yet. Kate and Wolf.
It's really fascinating and interesting. And this isn't the first time. Yeah. This isn't the only part of the movie that historians are picking apart.
They've been kind of picking it apart a little bit since the movie was released. Nothing really major, but a couple of things they say: that Mary Todd Lincoln would not have been in the House of Representatives monitoring the vote and everything like the movie depicts. They say that, you know, slavery was not abolished just by this one vote. There was a lot of other things going on at the time. But they do say it gets a lot right. The arm twisting, the wrangling, the horse trading in Congress, that's very accurately depicted. And, of course, the portrayal of Lincoln by Daniel Day-Lewis, very accurate.
Yeah, if you get a response from Spielberg or Kushner or any of them, let us know.
We'll do.